which is we are all agreed that there's a shortfall of $2.5 trillion every year in investable resources beyond ODA and what governments can raise in the developing world to achieve the ambitions of Agenda 2030. So the question is, where is this going to come from? The answer is, we expect it to come from the private sector, from private investors. And then, what we are interested in is, what does it take to unlock the resources of the private sector? Not just the speculative movement of money or statistical but non-actual movement of money like what we see in financial inversion, shifting headquarters declaration for tax purposes, but in the concrete terms of greenfield projects, concrete investment in infrastructure, investment in sustainable sectors, sustainable goal sectors. We can't answer all those questions here, but I'd just like us to focus on one thing. How can we nurture dialogue that addresses optimal regulatory mechanisms, framework, to enable, to unleash the power of private partnerships? I say this in the context of two things. One, our traditional models of partnerships are not working well. They have not answered. If they had answered the question, there would be no question of $2.5 trillion financing gap. And secondly, the frontier of action is emerging and frontier markets, which on a risk-profit analysis have not been particularly attractive to many major investors. Third, a traditional competition to the bottom, a race to the bottom by developing countries to try to attract investors, have created prima facie very interesting possibilities, but in reality, undermining long-term viability. When you have an old stock of agreements where you offer the foreign investor better conditions than the domestic investor, one of the consequences was domestics round-tripping. That you are based in Nairobi, the Kenya government is giving better conditions to foreigners than to you, you register a company in Mauritius and invest in Kenya as a foreigner. These are concrete things happening today. A lot of my audience here know that that is true. So, how do you balance attractiveness to the foreign investor without breaching the most important rule that we know today, that the best way to impress a foreign investor is to impress a local investor? If you do it well and fix with the local business community, they are the best marketers to the foreign community. But it took us 30, 40 years to come to this reality because of trying to look too much on the foreigner instead of what is available locally. But that's just one level. The other level is, with rising complexity of international investment environment, there are new challenges that we have to surmount. There's a need for environmental regulation, labor standards regulation. The corporate sector on its own is driving benchmarking sustainable behavior. We're seeing the Global Compact, our partners from the private sector in the UN system, having very substantial ambitions about what's acceptable conduct. Major corporations starting to roll out their sustainability business models. Not just the PR of corporate social responsibility, but what you do internally as an organization, how many women are in management positions, how is the wage structure reflecting inclusivity in the benefits of your enterprises, how much are you embracing the principle that the largest taxes have to be paid in the territories where you get your most profits. These are issues that the private sector is driving up. Governments have to come through this soft law to start legislating what is comfortable for the private sector. How do you improve regulatory regime in an increasingly complex environment without burdening enterprise with too much compliance requirements? These are concrete challenges that those who have felt it and those who want to enter the market in the developing world want to deal with. And I hope by you sitting here together, you can pioneer in the context of Africa at such a premier event, talking to this challenge.